What's up, y'all? Tim Muriello here for I'llPumpYouUp.com. I would like to simply entitle this video The Abomination of Amino Acid Spiking. Now, if you have not heard the news, I hate to be the one to break it to you, okay? There's been a big company by the name of Body Fortress named in a class action lawsuit for what's called amino acid spiking. Now, before I go any further, I would like to show you I have actually made a video called Should You Buy Walmart Protein? Should I buy Walmart protein? And I told y'all not to buy the dang Walmart protein. Do not do it. You get what you pay for. And I read all these little comments. Oh, dude, he sells supplements. That's why he says don't buy the Walmart protein. Walmart protein's good. Wrong. I was right, because that's all they sell. I had to get that off my chest. All right, man. It was not just Body Fortress. There's actually many. Many is not one or two. I'm not talking about a couple or a few. I'm talking many other supplement companies that was actually named in the suspected amino acid spiking. Let me explain what amino acid spiking is, okay? It's also known as nitrogen spiking. So let's say you grab a tub of protein, all right? It says 24 grams of protein. You have worked your keister off. You're a working guy, you got a family to feed, you're trying to put your kids through school, make your bills, and you're trying to bodybuild, right? You spend your hard-earned money on a bucket of protein, hoping that there is really 24 grams of protein in that bucket of protein, right? Of course. You don't want to waste your money. You don't want to get ripped off either, do you? No, you don't. I'm going to try and make this very easy for you to understand. What these supplement companies are suspected of doing, let's say there's 24 grams of protein on the label, not in the bucket, on the label. Well, what they're doing is even up to 50% of that 24 grams of protein are actually cheap, almost worthless amino acids that have nothing to do with building muscle. You're probably saying, well, how the heck, how can they put it on the label? How can they get away with this? I'm glad you asked. When they test a product out to see how much protein is in a product, they do what's called a nitrogen test, okay? This nitrogen test measures how much nitrogen is in the product. So if they say, run it through a test and say, all right, yep, there was 24 grams of protein in here per the nitrogen content. Well, guess what? These cheap amino acids like glycine, taurine, even creatine, they actually give off more of a nitrogen measurement in a lot of cases than whey protein. They don't actually test what's in those 24 grams of protein. They test the nitrogen content, and that's how they give you 24 grams of protein or X amount of grams of protein. It's bullcrap. If you're buying these products, you could not be getting the full amount. Maybe even you're only getting 50% whey protein and the rest is complete garbage. I do have 7 quick thoughts about this abominable amino acid spiking. The first one is these companies suspected of completely ripping people off. Freaking just taking money right out of their freaking wallet, right? Number 2, it's vicious lying and absolute deceit. Number 3, those are gains you could have been making. Not only did they suspected of stealing your money, but they're suspected of even worse, stealing your gains, man.
Oh, hey.
Right? Number 4, I do feel this should be punishable as a war crime under the Geneva Convention. Number 5, it ruins the supplement industry. Ruins it, bro. People already lack trust in the supplement industry. When this kind of crap hits, dude, it ruins it for everybody. It really does. Numbers drop in an industry that, you know, where trust is critical. All right? Number 6, it introduces and invites government scrutiny. I don't know if you knew this or not. There's actually people in government right now that would prefer that people not even buy supplements, all right? They don't even want you, some of these people don't even want you to be able to go to the store and buy a bucket of protein or buy a test booster or creatine. Number 7, it's complete evil, right? Now, should you stop buying a bucket of protein? Heck no, I will still buy protein powder, my man, all right? Listen, this could happen with anything, dude. It could happen, I don't care if you're on the juice, bro, you're trying to buy some stuff off your homeboy. It could happen in hair product, it could happen in cleaning products. It can happen in food. It can happen in anything. There's always going to be a level of unscrupulousness. Is that a word, bro? There's gonna be a level of unhonesty in any facet of any industry. It's gonna happen. People are gonna say that you're gonna get this, you're gonna get that. Broken promises, blah, 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 right? Obviously, you know, whey protein is very, very convenient, which it is. And there's a lot of cases where I don't care who you are. You simply don't have time to eat whole foods. You need a bucket of protein to quickly slam down. Maybe at work, working on cars, whatever the situation is. And there's some, these protein powders, a lot of times food can't replicate whey protein, okay? For instance, I drink Optimum Nutrition Pro Complex. Man, I sound like an advertisement. Listen, I do drink Optimum Nutrition Pro Complex. Dude, low carb, low fat, 15.5 grams of branched chain amino acids, 10.5 grams of glutamine, 60 grams of protein. Dude, you just can't get that in whole foods. If you do, you're gonna have to eat tons of it. Plus, dude, whey protein has the highest amount of leucine in any food product, okay? And you do, whey is food, all right? It is, whey is actually food, all right? So again, sometimes you cannot get that in whole foods. So I got a couple things I'm gonna tell you to help you avoid getting bamboozled, avoid getting, wasting your money, wasting your gains. And I want you to listen to these because I think they're gonna help you make a good buying decision. Number one, stick to long-standing trusted supplement lines. Some of my favorites, and there's many, I'm just naming a few. Some good ones are BSN, Optimum Nutrition, Nature's Best, ProLab, Universal, guys that have been in the industry for a long time. Read labels. Take the time to read some labels. If you see in the ingredients, it's saying arginine, taurine, glycine, creatine, you don't want that protein, okay? You don't want it. You want something that literally the first ingredient is whey protein. Number three, do some research. Don't be a lazy freaking butt, man. Take some time, do some research on these companies. Find out what kind of certifications these companies have had, what kind of, trusted affiliations they're a part of. Do your research. Make sure you're dealing with a trusted company that's putting a product out and the labels match up what's actually in the product. Number four, and the last thing I'm gonna tell you is cheap is not always better, okay? There's an old saying, you get what you pay for, i.e. Walmart protein, like I was telling y'all not to dang buy. Do not do it. You get what you pay for. Do your research, read the labels, go with trusted companies, and don't always try to go for the cheapest bucket of protein, all right? You get what you pay for. Guys, I hope I've educated you. I hope, hopefully you've gotten some good information from this. Don't forget to subscribe. Give me a like. Tune in next time.
You get what you pay for. You get what you pay for. You get what you pay for. You get what you pay for.